There's just no point in regretting stuff because it's done. There's no use crying over spilt milk. It's over. Hey y'all, it's your girl from Elio. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. Make sure to like this video because it helps other people to see the video. And make sure to subscribe because we got awesome content on this channel. Today, I'm coming to you guys with a video talking about things that we need to let go before we enter 2022. So these are things that we just need to leave in 2021. Now, the first thing that we need to leave in 2021 that we do not need to bring into 2022 is procrastinating. Oh my goodness, you guys. I feel like this is a struggle for a lot of people, and me too. I will literally know I have to do something and I'm gonna go to sleep. You know what I mean? Like literally. Or I'll just be scrolling on Instagram or TikTok nowadays, honestly. Or I'll just be like, okay, after two more YouTube videos, then I'm gonna do it. Procrastination is the devil. Oh my goodness. We're allowing things to get in the way of our goals and get in the way of us living our best lives and becoming the people that we want to be. So why would we want to do that? Trying to set things in place so that we don't have to procrastinate and just kind of pushing ourselves. And if we have to, getting accountability partners or just being more convicted and being like, I'm gonna get it done. You know what I mean? I'm just gonna go ahead and do it. So there's that. The second thing that we do not need to bring into 2022 is failing to plan. This, oh my goodness, this is such a struggle because the thing about it is you don't really realize, oh man, if I had just planned things properly, it would be so much better until you're actually in the midst of what you're doing and things are not going that great. Like for example, with moving, I always wish that I started packing earlier. Every time I have moved, I always wish like, oh man, I should have planned properly to pack earlier or plan properly so you can either hire movers, right? Or ask the right people to help you move and give them enough time to plan their schedules appropriately so that they're even available to help you move. Different things like that. Or even with our goals. How many times do we have goals and we literally just throw it out there? Oh, I want to do this, but no plan in sight. So do you really want to do it? You know, it's giving. Like, it's not giving what it's supposed to give. You know, we really need to plan. And I really want to plan more in 2022 because I think that that's a key thing, especially if you really get worried and you really get in your head about stuff. Planning is a huge help for that because I have seen the difference between when I have planned things out properly and when I have not. And clearly, you know, the results are different, number one. And number two, it's just such a smoother experience. Like, let's not bring unnecessary stress into 2022, please, you know? So that is something that I am gonna try to work on. And then maybe you might want to too. The third thing is worrying with no action. This has been big for me. This has been huge. This was huge in 2021 for me where I'll just be so concerned about something. I'll be worrying. I'm in my head. I'm feeling bad. I'm this, I'm that. Just, you know, literally you're essentially torturing yourself, right? But you're not actually taking action. If you, it's the serenity prayer. God, please help me to change. I think it's change the things. I'll put it up on the screen. Change the things that I can control and accept the things that I can't. It's either you can change it or you can't. Move it along. And I am really learning that because I've been watching these YouTube videos and one YouTuber in particular that I love, and she always says it gets to be easy, right? So it's either happening or it's not. There is no like, I don't need to be worried. I don't need to do all of that because it's not changing anything. If I want different results, I can go ahead and just work toward having different results. Literally, I'll tell you, even give you an example, like I'll constantly be refreshing my YouTube studio. I'll refresh it. See, am I having new subscribers? How are my numbers doing? I'm constantly doing that. Literally, like it's too much. OD, I do it OD. And the thing about it is, the time I'm doing that, not saying that I'm not also working on other YouTube stuff in the background, but instead of just doing it so much, I could be planning out new videos. I could be filming content. I could be pushing myself toward actually doing something to get different results versus consistently refreshing over and over and over again. I'm not gonna lie though, I am gonna still consistently be refreshing my YouTube studio to see my numbers, but not as much as I did last year without putting in more effort, you know? Cause it's just literally me waiting around for results for some work that I've already done when I can be working towards doing more to get to the goal that I'm trying to achieve. Honestly, guys, we have to either choose to accept things the way they're gonna be or actively work to change them. Worrying does nothing. You're torturing yourself for fun, literally. I had to talk to myself like, girl, what are you doing here? What are you doing? Who is this helping? You know what I mean? I've been working more on it and I'm pretty happy with my growth so far, but I'm really gonna double down on it and try my best not to worry. It's hard, you know? We're gonna worry, but if we can try and minimize that worry and instead work and put in action into changing things to get a different result versus just waiting around. I'm speaking about like worrying about like goals and stuff like that versus just sitting around and just waiting for things to change. And this could even go for relationships because a lot of things we just need to accept. It happened, it is what it is. Accept it and move on. We just gotta keep pushing. Worrying, it doesn't help anything. We could do it for a little bit if you have to. And if I have to, I'll do it for a little bit, but I gotta move it along, honestly. So the next thing that we gotta leave in 2021 and not bring it to this new year, you guessed it, fear and anxiety. This has been so much of a hindrance, I feel like, for a lot of us. It's literally the devil. You're killing yourself from the inside out. And we gotta stop that. We gotta stop that. And this is me talking to me. This is me talking to you too, but it's also me talking to me. No, 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 no. I told myself, I really don't want to walk in fear. I don't want to walk in fear. You know, I don't want to live in anxiety. It's not good. It's not helpful. If you need some sort of motivation, it should be something else. Obviously, fight or flight, these are instincts that you have to have. Like there's like a healthy amount of fear to like assess the situation and know that you need to leave or this, that, and the third. But at the same time, not to live in fear and just anxiety and all just be in your head. And it's just not fun. It's not fun, especially if you're an overthinker like myself. I feel like maybe a lot of us, it can be very easy to go into that anxiety route, but we don't have to do that. We don't have to live that way. If we want, we can still overthink it. We can still overthink things, but you don't have to get into that negative space. It's just not, it's not fun, it's not a good time, and it's not helpful toward your goals and toward living life and just toward your overall aura and your energy. It's just, it kills, it's not good. So learning like how to deal with that and prevent it is what I'm aiming to bring in to this new year and just try and prevent fear and anxiety from hindering my life. Another thing is beating yourself up, that negative self-talk. I will say this, I am very hard on myself. I am very hard on myself. And I will say it has been helpful to a degree. I have been able to achieve, I have been able to achieve certain things that I'm proud of because I am hard on myself and because I do push myself. But we gotta know the difference between pushing yourself and motivating yourself for greatness versus beating yourself up and literally just being a negative Nancy to yourself. You know what I mean? And I used to kind of pride myself in the fact that like, there's probably nothing negative that somebody can say about me that hasn't already ran through my mind about myself where I've assessed like, okay, this is true about me or this is not true about me. But the thing about it is, you don't even want to be, obviously be self-aware, know what your weaknesses and your strengths, but you don't want to be your own hater. You don't want to be down on yourself like, man, you don't want to talk down like, oh man, you're such an idiot. Like, why would you do that? You're so dumb. Like, oh my goodness, you're always in this. You're not a good person. You're not this, you're not that. Like, you don't look good. You don't, da, 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 da. All those type of negativity. No, not helpful, not helpful. If you want to tell yourself, I'm a realist though. I do believe in being honest with yourself, but okay, it's like a different, how you do it. It's how you talk to yourself. I thought to myself, I forget when it was, but I was like, yeah, I want to start talking better to myself. I want to be nicer to me. You know, I want to talk to myself like how I talk to my friends, how I encourage them and how I do this. Don't get me wrong, though, I give myself the best pep talks ever. But that negative self-talk, I need to get it out of here. It needs to go, okay? So that is something that you can implement also to leave in 2021 and bring in positive self-talk and positive affirmations and only speaking positivity over your life and to yourself in 2022. Another thing is overcomplicating things and overexplaining yourself. I do this a lot. I overexplain myself a lot. I remember talking to my mom about it because we were going back and forth on something. She's like, why are you doing that? We disagreed on it, a certain scenario. And I was trying to get her to see why I felt the way I felt to try and change her perception. And she's like, no, you got to be confident in your decision. You shouldn't have to explain. You shouldn't have to keep on explaining yourself. Why you keep doing that? And I'm like, whoa, you're right. You're right. And I told her the truth is because I care about what you think about me. So I want to make sure I'm trying to control the perception so you can understand me better to really perceive it correctly. You know what I mean? So literally it hit me. I was like, I got to stop doing that. You know, because my mindset was if you care about somebody, you're going to explain yourself. You will, or technically over-explain yourself to them because you want them to understand you're not coming from a bad place. You want them to understand your mindset and the logic that went into you making the decisions that you make, right? But there is a line. There is a line between chill out. Like it's not that deep. You don't owe me that much explanation. And there's a line between, okay, yeah, like, you care about this person, give them this information. So that's what it is. And that's what I'm learning. Because sometimes even with strangers and stuff like that, just like caring too much about how people perceive you. I think that's what it boils down to. So you're over explaining yourself, you know, and it's not the move. It's not the move. It's something that I want to be mindful because I know I do it. I want to be mindful of doing it, of not doing it in this new year. And then the overcomplicating of things, you know, sometimes when things are simple, we just go ahead and we're like, nah, that's too easy. It's gotta be something else. There's gotta be something there. Or we find the negative part that could form out of it and we magnify on the negative possibilities versus the actuality of what is in front of us. And sometimes I find myself doing that. And I feel like it comes from a place where you're not walking in gratitude. Like, it's okay to just be like, okay, this is what it is. It's simple, and not try to make it deeper than what it is and complicate matters so that you're not able to be present and fully appreciate whatever is in front of you. And you know, having that mindset of this is too good to be true, or making things harder than what they have to be. You know, sometimes things are really 1 + 1 = 2. It's not freaking 32,560 divided by 43.654. You know what I mean? It's not that deep. It's really just not that deep. And it doesn't always have to be that deep. And I know that some of it comes from like trying to be on guard just in case something might, you know, you're trying to be prepared in case something might negative might come up. But sometimes things are allowed to just be good, you know? Another thing is not prioritizing what's most important. I feel like it's very easy just to be getting lost in the sauce and really losing focus on the things that are most important to us. Although with things going on now, it has been a little bit more easy to realize like, okay, you can be gone like this, so focus on A, B, C, or D. But as a general rule of thumb, just making sure that we're prioritizing the things that if we were to die today, we would care about the most, you know, and not so much fussing over the little stuff, you know, just making sure that our priorities are straight. Another thing is to be careful with regret. Let's try and have no regrets. And I'm going to tell you this, like the type of regrets I'm talking about are purchases, right? Purchases and like with food, you know, sometimes... Me and my mom, we were talking about it. My mom was telling me, like, you know, even with food, like, if you're going to eat it, okay, you ate it. Just be happy you ate it. It is what it is. There's no need to regret it now. You done already ate the whole pizza. You ate it. You ate the whole box. You know what? What difference does it make now if you're sad about it? You know, like, no regrets going into 2022. If you're going to splurge, you're going to buy the bag. You're going to buy the shoes. All right, you bought it. It's either you're going to keep it or you're going to return it. If you can't return it, okay then, sis, be happy. It is what it is. Like, there's just no point in regretting stuff because it's done. There's no use crying over spilt milk. It's over, you know? So another thing I would say is consuming too much content. Especially as a creative, I had to be mindful of this. When you're getting so much information, it's just like, it's an overload. Information overload, too much stimulus. Like, you don't have a chance to just have a blank slate and a clear mind to really be creative and really foster your own ideas. You can kind of get bogged down with what's all in the media or other people's mindsets and stuff like that. You really just have to be careful with that, is what I realized for myself, because I'm a lover of all things creative, so I love consuming other people's content, but you know, there's a limit. I gotta chill out. So maybe that's something that you also have to be mindful of. And some things that I plan on doing, I did this before. I did, you know, the whole IG timer where they time how long you're on IG. I did it before and not often, you know, I kept on going past my limit, but I think I'm gonna do it again. And I think I'm also gonna be mindful of my time also on YouTube and TikTok, because now TikTok is a whole, it's a new black hole over there. Like, it's lit. It's lit on TikTok. Follow me at funla.ib. But trying to limit my time on those different apps, because very easily can spend a whole day on there. And it kind of drains you, honestly. It drains you and you're not able to put your energy into other things. It's also a distraction. So being intentional with my use of it is something that I want to make sure to do in 2022, because these are all great sources for creativity, knowledge, inspiration, and all that type of stuff. Like, they're all great resources, but when you overuse them, it's just not the best. And then the last thing is not getting enough sleep. I definitely want to get more sleep, because I realize when I don't sleep well, it's just not good. The brain is foggy. I don't really feel good. I can't be fully present. I can't really fully be there with people. I can't perform my best. I am my best when I get a good night's rest. So why would I stand in my own way?